Dear students, welcome to the next lecture in this video series. In this lecture, we will be learning single stage transistor amplifier in a very simplified manner. This presentation is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronics Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune. In this lecture, we are going to learn single stage transistor amplifier circuit diagram, various circuit elements and function of each component, various currents flowing in the circuit, and finally the phase reversal of input and output in the circuit. There will be a question worth 3 to 4 marks in the exam on this particular topic, as to draw circuit diagram of single stage amplifier and explain the function of each component. So let's begin. Single stage transistor amplifier. So this diagram shows the circuit of single stage transistor amplifier, and it consists of various elements. Firstly, it's a transistor. In the figure, you will see this is an NPN transistor. Then R1, R2, RC and RE, they form the voltage divider biasing network. Cin is the input coupling capacitor. CC is the output coupling capacitor. RL is the load resistance across which the output is taken. VCC is the supply given to establish the biasing in the circuit. Vin is the input signal, sinusoidal, and Vout is the output signal, which is in amplified form. Let us learn the function of each component. Number one, the biasing circuit. The resistors R1, R2, RC, RE, they form the biasing and stabilization circuit. The biasing circuit must provide a proper operating point. Otherwise, a part of negative half cycle of the signal may be cut off in the output. This biasing network also establishes the operating point in the middle of the active region. Next is the input capacitor Cin. An input capacitor Cin, which is approximately of 10 microfarad, allows only AC signal to flow inside the transistor. Also, it couples the signal to the base of the transistor. If it is not used, the signal source resistance will come across this R2 and may change the biasing condition. Next is emitter bypass capacitor CE. An emitter bypass capacitor CE, which typical value is approximately 100 microfarad, is used in parallel with RE to provide a low reactance path to the amplified AC signal. If it is not used, then amplified AC signal flowing through RE will cause a voltage drop across it, thereby reducing the output voltage, thereby reducing the gain of the transistor. Next is coupling capacitor CC. The coupling capacitor CC, typical value is approximately 10 microfarad, couples one stage of amplifier to the next stage. If it is not used, then the bias conditions of the next stage may get changed. This is because this RC will come in parallel with the upper resistance R1 of the biasing circuit of the next stage, thereby changing biasing conditions of the next stage. Thus, coupling capacitor CC isolates the DC of one stage from the next stage, but allowing AC signal to pass through it. Now let us learn about various circuit currents which flows in the circuit. Number one, the base current. When no signal is applied in the circuit, DC base current capital I with suffix capital B flows due to biasing network. After the application of AC signal, AC base current small I with small suffix B flows. So the total base current IB is given by capital IB, matlab the DC biasing current, plus the AC biasing current after applying the AC input voltage. Next is collector current. Again, when no signal is applied, a DC collector current capital I with suffix C flows due to biasing circuit. When AC signal is applied, an AC collector current small I with small suffix C flows in the circuit. So the total collector current will be equal to the DC collector current plus the AC collector current which arises due to the application of the input signal. Next is emitter current. When no signal is applied, a DC emitter current capital I with suffix E flows. With the application of signal, total emitter current small I with suffix capital E is given by IE is equal to DC emitter current plus the AC emitter current which flows under the application of input signal. But IE is equal to IB plus IC. This is our regular important relation, which usual relation we know. So therefore IE will be equal to IB plus IC. So this is the relation of emitter current. Usually the base current is very small, therefore the DC emitter current will be equal to DC collector current, and the AC emitter current will be approximately equal to the AC collector current. This is the current when input signal is applied, and these are the currents, emitter and collector currents, when under zero signal conditions. Now in CE configuration, when input signal increases in positive direction, the output voltage increases in negative direction. Thus, there is a phase difference of 180 degrees between input and output voltages in CE connection. Now, another term, important term, voltage gain. So, voltage gain of amplifier is the ratio of AC output voltage to the AC input signal voltage. So, voltage gain, A is the notation, AV, V stands for voltage. So, voltage gain is equal to ratio of V out by V in. Now the following graph shows a phase reversal in CE configuration with the help of output characteristics and load line. So AB is the load line and this is the IC versus VC, the output characteristics of a transistor in common emitter configuration at constant values of IB. So this is the variation of IB, this is the variation of IC, and this is the variation of VCE. In figure, AB is the load line. When base current is maximum in the positive direction, VCE becomes maximum in the negative direction. That means point G. If you consider point G, when base current is maximum, IB max in the positive direction, then VCE becomes maximum in the negative direction. So this is VCE in the negative direction. IB becomes maximum in the positive direction. VCE is becoming maximum in the negative direction at point G. When base current is maximum in the negative direction, that means here IB minimum, VCE is maximum in the positive direction at point H. At point H, IB is maximum in the negative direction and VCE is maximum in the positive direction. So, input and output voltages are 180 degree out of phase with respect to signal voltage. It is also clear from this waveforms. That's all for this lecture. Stay tuned for the next series in the lecture. Please do visit our YouTube video channel FYJC Vocational Electronics for all the video lectures in this series. Subscribe, like, share, and stay tuned.